Hey guys, welcome on this video. So you still don't see the option Enroll Now for security updates for Windows 10? You are waiting and you don't see the option yet, okay? I have a lot of comments and I see that in some computers, this option is not yet available, depends on the region, okay? But I had the same problem with my Core 2 Duo processor today and I found out that I have some registry keys that are missing in my computer. So today I'm going to show you and fix your registry keys on your Windows 10, fix your Windows 10, make it ready for the option to show up, okay? So it's just 1 month away, okay? So in 14 October, Windows 10 will end support. So we are here to find the method to fix it, make it possible. Continue watching the video and see my methods. So when you come here on Windows update area, then you check for updates and everything. You did everything. You did the update. You are on the latest version of Windows 10 and you don't have any updates anymore. I mean, you don't have any updates left. So you install everything. Now you see that you don't see the option here to enroll to get Windows 10 ESU enrollment process is not showing. On Tips to Fix website, I did this blog to help you guys to make this possible and prepare your Windows for this. You can do it by yourself manually, or you can use the bat file that I created for you and will explain you later. We are going to prepare our Windows and make sure that we have files on the registry editor. If we miss those files, then you will not be able to see the option. So what I did, I created quick method and another method is full method if the fast method doesn't work, okay? Let me continue directly to the point. I will go with the fast method and then we will see. Just copy this command and go to CMD. Now with this command, we are checking if this connected user experience is not disabled, guys, because maybe it's disabled and you don't see that, okay? Now what I'm going to do, just bring paste here. Oh, access is denied because everything we need to do it in as administrator. What you are going to do, go here on run again, go to CMD, command prompt, run as administrator. Yes. Change service configuration is success. So click enter. Oh, the instance of the service is already running. Okay. Now, we finish with the first step. Now we go to second step. We need to add this at the following registry. If you use this command, go and copy and paste, just copy and paste like I did here, or just copy and paste. What this command do is create this registered word in our registry file editor. Okay, I'm going to show you right now. So open up CMD again. So it's already open. Right click and it will be paste. Click enter and the operation complete successfully. Let me show you here. Reg editor. Here on HK local machine system, current control set policies. Microsoft, this folder was missing. So now it's created because of this script. Okay, you see? So we are creating this. Microsoft feature management overrides. This was missing in my case. Now we just create it. Here is the file that we created, okay? We put the value of data on 2 here. We need to restart the system. Then after restart, we need to use this command, okay? Restart the computer now. This is the moment to restart computer. Close. So I did restart the computer. Now going back to the post and get the commands that we need. We need to go all the way down. Here it is. Now we are here. We need this command. Okay. Copy this command completely. And now what we're going to do, open up CMD again, run as administrator as always, copy the command again. So now I did this. Let's check if it works or not. If you see a non-zero value, it works. If you see 0, 0 or nothing, we didn't see anything, move to the full method. Now let's go and check this method, if this will work or not. This is the easiest. I mean, here it is. Windows support ends on October. Now you can click this button, enroll. Okay? So we are able right now with three clicks. If you have any problem, if you still don't see this option, and then you have to go to full method. Now, guys, I wrote this script for you. Let's edit and let's see what is inside. Now, what I'm going to do, let me show you the script. Run as administrator. Enable consumer ESU fast method, the one that I showed you. But this is with one click. And then you have to restart the computer. First of all, you have to click one and enter. And then after restarting the computer, you have to go again to the script and click three. Okay. So now if you wanted to remove these changes that I did, just open up the script and click four. And then we can disable, remove everything. Okay. This full method is recommended if fast method doesn't work or fails. Okay. Now in my case, it's working well, and you see now I'm able to enroll. Now let's disable it. You remove the features. Okay, the operation completed successfully. Press any key. If the first method doesn't work, use the second method. You have just to type number two. Okay, the operation completed successfully. After that, it will ask you for restarting the computer. You will come back. It will come back again. Look at this, task complete. Enable full method. Please restart your computer now. And then after restart this script again, choose the option three to check the eligibility like we did, okay? But make sure your computer is updated. You have the security updates installed on your computer, okay? You have to be on the latest updates on your Windows 10. If you wanted to know now how to enroll, I did another video tutorial for that. Go ahead, watch here on the cards. And you will find the video in the description to see how to enroll and get extended security updates from Microsoft for 1 year more. So as you already see, you don't have to use the second method. If it works directly, like in my case, then go ahead. So you already had the problem in your Windows. That's the reason why you didn't see the enrollment button on Windows update. Okay. If you don't want to stay on Windows 10 anymore and you are trying to install Windows 11 on your computer, but it show up those message that your computer is not supported processor or something, I did another video tutorial on how to install Windows 11 on unsupported processors. Not all of them. I mean, if your computer is Core 2 dual processor, then I did another video tutorial only for you guys. Go ahead, watch these two video tutorials that I already did to make it possible. I just wanted to thank you guys that you watched this video tutorial today. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. I will make great video tutorials for you. I will make your life easier. I'm here to fix problems. So if you have something, just write me a comment, let me know. So as you already know, God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.